It says grandpa's, we just go straight into tempo, straight back to the sun.
So it goes. Dun, 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 dun. No.
It's hard to watch.
Dun, 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 dun. Okay, there.
So don't do any grandpa's, just go straight back to
the
sun.
Song goes.
You good?
One. All repeats good.
Yeah, just as written, but no grandpa's. I'm with you at the beginning.
Got it.
Thank you.
Is that the trumpet solo?
I don't think we can play Jingle Bells twice in a row.
Oh, let's get some of that. What about this Oh Holy Night, Bossa Nova style?
Oh Holy Night?
Oh yeah.
227-30.
It's long.
I think, I don't know what time it is. If you got 4, it's still 5.
It's not shorter?
No.
No?
I don't think they're even briefing yet.
730?
227-30 Oh Holy Night.
All down
trumpet.
There.
Yeah.
Okay.
Ready? 1, 2, 1, 2.
The light is nice.
I know. Except that's what I said, we're gonna cast our own shadows. At least I'm not twitching. Okay boys. Maybe we should slow down. Let's see what else we have to play.
You can whip through this.
I know, but I wanna do if they're gonna have a briefing. We can't play that one as per Boylan said no way.
For what, real?
The one that's next.
We can't do Southern.
No. We can do Kings, there's a bunch of Kings.
Is there one that works?
Santa Claus is coming to town?
How about this up on the housetop? Oh, this is the worst. Yeah, we do the three Kings. Okay.
What about Santa
Claus? Andrew said no for that one. He's got a stupid trumpet.
What's next?
Rudolph. I'm just playing the next one after.
Cool.
No repeat.
No repeat. Just like we rehearsed it.
You doing it?
Yeah, right.
Thank you.
Three Kings 22614. There's improv for the trumpet to just make something up.
I think that's the definition of improv, right?
Trying to help.
Ooh, Sussex.
We can't. Let's go.
So you blow and you got a cuist to the head. You cuist when you stop. Remember that?
It's the sax method.
You want changes?
Well, just something. It doesn't matter.
Something.
Is anything written
other than science?
I mean, do you want me to do it?
Greg can do it.
It's just B flat.
Greg will do it.
Just D minor.
Greg will do it.
As you said, I'll make some.
I know. You counting off, Johnny.
Okay, here we go. Two bars. One, two, three, one.
Deck the Halls is in the little book.
Number, please.
Number, let's see it. 13 little book in the little book. And let's just play it as written really quick.
Let's see it.
I know.
Deck the Halls.
13. Number 13. Number just play it straight as written. So repeat first thing and then to end it.
Repeat, yes, you got it.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Speaker Nancy Pelosi, Republican Leader Kevin McCarthy, Senator Dianne Feinstein, Chairperson Zoe Lofgren, Representative Jared Huffman, Representative Doug LaMalfa, Chief Randy Moore of the United States Department of Agriculture's Forest Service, Mr. J. Brett Blanton, Architect of the United States Capitol, and Michael Mavris, fifth grade student from Crescent City, California. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable J. Brett Blanton, Architect of the United States Capitol.
Good evening, and welcome to the 57th Annual Christmas Tree Lighting Ceremony at the United States Capitol. I'm Brett Blanton, the Architect of the Capitol. I'm honored to be joining you here this evening as Speaker Nancy Pelosi and student Michael Mervis light the 2021 Capitol Christmas Tree. This year's tree comes to us from the Six Rivers National Forest in the great state of California. I'd like to thank the United States Forest Service for finding and delivering this wonderful 84-foot tall white spruce tree to the Capitol. We truly appreciate their efforts year after year to help make this festive tradition a success. Additionally, I want to thank everyone involved in the transportation of this tree, nicknamed Sugar Bear, to the United States Capitol. It took a 4,500-mile trek across country to get here. Additionally, I'd also like to thank my team here at the Architect of the Capitol who decorated the tree and set up for this event. Specifically, I want to recognize Arborist Supervisor Rick Prince and Arborist Leader Buddy Patty. They are both retiring at the end of this year. Rick has more than 37 years of service, and Buddy has more than 24. Together, they have the abundance of experience in making this tree shine as it graces the front of the Capitol. Lighting the Christmas tree has been a tradition since 1964, and it's one we're glad to continue this year. We are delighted to have this beautiful Capitol Christmas tree that all Californians, and frankly, all Americans, can be proud of. Finally, it is my honor to welcome all distinguished guests this evening, our Capitol Hill neighbors, and those who are visiting the nation's capital. We're so happy you braved this weather to celebrate this most wonderful time of the year. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chief Randy Moore of the United States Department of Agriculture's Forest Service.
Thank you for the opportunity to say a few words on behalf of the Forest Service and the United States Department of Agriculture. Each year, the Capitol Christmas tree comes from a different state, from a different national forest across the United States. The tree this year comes from the people of California, from the Mad River Ranger District on the Six Rivers National Forest. The theme in Six Rivers, many communities, one people. It's a reminder that we as a people are diverse, and from diversity comes strength. Strength as a people with common values and shared goals. So on behalf of the Forest Service and all the partners and volunteers who brought us this tree, I wish you a season's greeting. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Doug LaMalfa, representing the 1st Congressional District of California.
Well, good evening. Madam Speaker, thank you for the invite tonight and all my colleagues I get to join the stage with here. I'm really excited about this, for this Capitol Christmas tree. Indeed, it is a white fir, has come from Northwest California in the Six Rivers National Forest, which me and my colleague, Mr. Huffman, share over there in the Northwest. trucked all the way across the country by six different drivers. Our forest up there overlaps four counties in Northwest California as well. Our nation's forests indeed are one of our greatest natural resources and a vital industry in my district and all through the West. I'm very blessed to have the opportunity to represent such a beautiful district and such a resilient people. This summer alone in my district, we saw nearly 1.7 million acres burned by wildfires. Tonight, many who have been affected by major fires of the past years are still struggling to rebuild. With proper forest management practices, we can reduce the damages done by wildfires and help keep our water and air supplies clean, our towns and wildlife habitat safer. As ranking member of the Agricultural Committee's Conservation and Forestry Subcommittee, I work to safeguard our forested communities and provide rural economies and healthy forests. This Christmas season, I celebrate the opportunity to worship together with loved ones, the resilience of our nation in the face of adversity, and the fundamental rights granted to us as citizens of this great country, and the freedom to express our faith. I rejoice in the reason for the season, birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. I would like to wish you all a Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Jared Huffman, representing the 2nd Congressional District of California.
Hi, everyone. It is such a pleasure to be with you to celebrate this year's Capitol Christmas tree, which comes from my district and the Six Rivers National Forest. Now, I am very biased, I'll admit that up front, but I think I represent one of the most beautiful places in the world, and it is an honor, not just for me, but for all of my constituents, that we get to share a piece of that beautiful place with the Capitol and with the rest of the country this holiday season. This year's tree is a symbol of the beauty and the importance of our nation's public lands. And it's a reminder of our responsibility to conserve public lands so that everyone, including future generations, can continue to enjoy them. I'm also very proud to have my constituent, fifth grader Michael Mavris, with us here as our tree lighter tonight. He won an essay contest to be the official tree lighter, and his heartfelt essay is a great addition to this holiday tradition. Michael, we're all very excited to watch you flip the switch here in a moment to light up Sugar Bear. So thanks everyone for being here to celebrate this piece of our home, and special thanks to the Six Rivers National Forest for sharing Sugar Bear with us and the rest of the country. Happy holidays.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Lo Lofgren, Chairperson of the Committee on House Administration, representing the 19th Congressional District of California.
Well, thank you very much. What an honor and pleasure it is to be here this evening celebrating the season, but also this tree. I know that all of our California colleagues, those who are speaking and those who are just here, share the pride that we all feel that this beautiful tree, Sugar Bear, is standing as a symbol of California and a symbol for our nation. You know, the tree went across the country, but before it did, it went around California so that everybody in our state would have a chance to feel the pride that I have and all of us have today. This Christmas tree tradition has been going on for many, many decades. It's important, and especially important now. I hope that as we celebrate with our families and our colleagues, we can also see that this tree is an opportunity for us to be more united than sometimes we are. And let's celebrate that for our country. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Dianne Feinstein, United States Senator from California.
Thank you very much. I'm honored to join everyone here today, along with the architect of the Capitol, the United States Forest Service, and members of the California delegation. We're here to kick off the holiday season with the signing, or the lighting, excuse me, of this beautiful Capitol Christmas tree. just to learn a little bit more about the tree. It's named Sugar Bear. It comes from the Six Rivers National Park, and that's in the northwest part of our state, California. It comes from over 4,000 feet in elevation. That's where it grew up. And Sugar Bear is 84 feet tall and only 19 feet wide. So it's tall and slim. I'd like very much to thank all of the California children who made the ornaments that make this tree look so special. Guess what? There are 15,000 ornaments on this tree. That's the most ever created by one state in the history of the Capitol Christmas tree. Would you give the children a big round of applause who made these ornaments, please? We're very proud of the number and the quality. California's forests, as Nancy Pelosi and other members here certainly know, face many challenges, most notably persistent drought and wildfires. I hope that this Congress and the Biden administration will really focus on those things and that we'll be able to do something about it. Because trees like this need water, and water has to come and they have to live. So I hope as we celebrate this Christmas season, we recognize that we must do everything we can to keep these beautiful trees, part of our heritage, alive, well, and thriving. Thank you, and Merry Christmas.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Kevin McCarthy, Republican leader of the United States House of Representatives, representing the 23rd Congressional District of California.
Thank you very much. And to all my colleagues, and especially my California colleagues, thank you for being part of it today. We've got the switch here. I will not push it early because we've got a special guest back there that won an essay contest. I went up to him. We said, are you the man? He says, yes, I'm the man. I'm excited. You know, you've heard a lot about this tree. You know where it came from. But when you think for one moment, what is a tree? A tree is the lungs of the earth. A tree breathes in CO2, captures the carbon, but releases the oxygen. It purifies. And so it's a rightful symbol of why we have it here. It's unique, as Senator Feinstein told you, the most ornaments ever, because it comes from the most populated state in our nation. It came from one end of our nation to the other. But of those six truck drivers that would drive this tree through the cities to let them celebrate and be a part of it, even if they couldn't be here today, I thank you. To the architect of the Capitol, to the U.S. Forest Service, and to all those individuals who made the ornaments, we want to thank you for the work you have done. Each of these people and many more have truly helped to transform this white fir into the people's tree here at the People's House. Tonight we celebrate the start of the Christmas season. As many of you might rush to buy gifts, if the supply chain helps us, let's remember the season and the reason for this season. Christmas is a time to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ and the blessing of God's love for all of us, the greatest gift we could ever receive. As we read in the book of Ephesians, each of us have been given his gift, a portion of Christ's bounty. Christmas is not just a time to be with family and friends, although spending that time with family and friends seems more important than almost any other time in the past. Christmas is a season to strive to mimic the example that Jesus taught us, to serve others and help those in need. Few emulate this more than our men and women in uniform and our first responders, who are spending this Christmas keeping us and the freedoms we enjoy safe. We thank them and their families for their sacrifices. Their service gives the rest of us the chance to celebrate this season in peace and safety. In my family, we have a tradition. Every Christmas, we go down to the mission, and we serve. We serve those in the need of our hometown. It always puts things in perspective. Whatever divides us, even politics, is not that great. Instead, we should all strive to follow Jesus' message of peace on earth and goodwill towards man. So as we prepare to light this Christmas tree, let's celebrate our many blessings. They are gifts to be grateful for. And let's never forget to share the gift this Christmas season to brighten the lives of others. If we can do that, I know we'll make tomorrow better than today. God bless and Merry Christmas.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Pierce Pearson, member of the Washington Performing Arts Children of the Gospel.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Here we are as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now. Here we are as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more. Through the years we all will be together, if the fates allow. Hang a shining star upon the highest bough, upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas now.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Nancy Pelosi, Speaker of the United States House of Representatives, representing the 12th District of California.
Good evening, everyone. Let us thank Pierce Pearson for that lovely, lovely rendition, his beautiful performance, and wishing us all a Merry Christmas. And I salute the United States Army Band, Pershing's own brass quartet, who bless us tonight with their warm, beautiful music. Thank you again. As Speaker of the House, it is my honor to welcome Americans from across the country, visually, virtually, and in person, to the annual lighting of the Capitol Christmas tree. And as a proud Californian, it is especially exciting that this 84-foot tree, white fir, hails from California's Six Rivers National Forest. You've heard that about four, five, or six times already this evening. And it is pretty, it's a source of pride for us. Let us thank the architect of the Capitol, Brett Blanton, the U.S. Forest Service Chief, Randy Moore, for making this possible for us. And I join my colleagues in thanking all who made this possible, those who selected and chopped down the tree, those who transported it here around the state of California and across the country, those who decorated the tree, the children who made the decorations, all who made this glorious occasion possible. Thank you, Architect Blanton and Forest Chief Moore. Thank you so much. Let's thank them. That's an applause line. For nearly six decades, the Capitol Christmas tree has stood on the West Front Lawn, bringing Americans together during the holiday season. In wartime and in peace, in tribulation and triumph, the Christmas tree has offered a sense of hope and resilience to the nation as we thank our men and women in uniform then and now and always. This tree is our symbol of hope. That has earned the endless nickname, the People's Tree, a testament to its special ability to unite us in comfort and joy, no matter who we are, where we're from. And that spirit inspires us tonight as we continue to battle the pandemic. So let us give thanks for the many blessings which God has bestowed upon us, in which we rejoice this holiday season, especially a miracle vaccine, the miracle vaccines that will allow us to safely be with loved ones. As we gaze upon this tree, let us recall the theme of this year's ceremony, Six Rivers, Many Peoples, One Tree. Indeed, this tree's roots are in the Six Rivers home, again, to beautiful natural and cultural diversity. Represent the tree itself is represented by Jared Hoffman. The forest is shared by Jared Hoffman and our dear colleague, Mr. LaMalfa. So this is a bipartisan tree, a nonpartisan tree. And isn't it perfectly symmetrical? Isn't it perfectly symmetrical? It is, again, the tree's roots are in Six Rivers, the home to beautiful natural and cultural diversity. In its journey here, it touched the lives of countless communities across the nation. And today, Americans from across the nation have gathered to bask in its light when it comes shortly. And as we gather here tonight, we remember our nation's greatest strength, our unity, and that each time our great nation has been tested, we have always been able to meet any moment and conquer any challenge together. I'm so honored to be here with our distinguished leader, Mr. McCarthy, all of our colleagues, Mr. LaMalfa, Mr. Hoffman, Ms. Lofgren, our dear Senator Dianne Feinstein, who is with us this evening, and those who have entertained us tonight. At our VIP tonight, our very important person is Michael Mavris, a fifth grader at Mary Peacock Elementary School in Crescent City, California, Mr. Hoffman's district. How fitting that he is here tonight. He, too, is from Six Rivers. In his winning essay, he wrote about the indomitable spirit of the land and its indigenous people. And he beautifully captured how this is reflected in the glorious tree before us. He has asked that before he lights the tree, that he share some of the words of his winning essay with you. So please welcome our very important person, Michael Mavris, to the podium.
Thank you. What is the theme, Six Rivers, Many Peoples, One Tree mean to me? As I ponder the question presented here, I consider where I am living, literally in the heart of the Six Rivers National Forest. Here, tucked deep within the northwestern corner of California, is a remote land whose majesty comes not from the achievements of humankind, but rather nature itself. Six mighty rivers crisscross this rugged land, from the Smith and Klamath rivers in the north, stretching over to the Eel and the Mad, meeting the Van Dusen and Trinity in the south. All of our rivers, amongst the cleanest in the world, represent life itself. Like the first peoples who have lived here since time immemorial, these rivers overcome every obstacle to ultimately reach their goal of becoming one with the Pacific Ocean. Is this done by an exhibition of power or show of strength? No. It is accomplished by sheer persistence, the indomitable spirit of never giving up, which is representative of this land and the peoples that live here. From the great tribes, the Yurok, Talawa, Karuk, Wiat, Chimariko, Nongatal, Hoopa, and Wailaki, we are taught to commune and truly be one with nature. This ethos teaches us to view rugged lands, secluded forests, and fierce weather patterns as something genuinely beautiful. Such is the story of the white fur, also known as the Abies Conqueror, whose beginnings trace back to a single seed. From this humble seed, dropped on a Mother Earth in a remote region, the process begins. Nurtured by the fertile soil, which the Six Rivers saturates throughout the year, and, against all apparent odds, not only confronts the weather, but embraces it, the young tree emerges proudly upwards towards the shining sun. From this great forest, we bring you the majestic white fir to be the capital Christmas tree. As the lights are strung and the ornaments placed, we, the people who live in the tree's symbolic shadow, hope that its beauty and grandeur provide a beacon to America and a reminder that on this Christmas, that all things are possible. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, Michael, now is the time when I invite all of the California delegation, including our distinguished speakers who we've heard from, but all of them to join in the countdown. And Michael is going to be swiftly, now you know how to do this, right?
Yes.
Okay, you push it up, okay? Make it push it up, okay. And now again, invite the California. Now we're counting from five. Five, four, three, two, one. Michael! Yay!
Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable J. Brett Blanton, Architect of the United States Capitol.
Thank you, everyone, for coming out to tonight's ceremony and joining Speaker Nancy Pelosi, the California delegation, the Forest Service, the United States Army Brass Quintet, and young Michael in lighting the U.S. Capitol Christmas tree. I wish you a healthy, happy, and safe holiday seasons. Thank you again.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain in place for the departure of the official party. Thank you for attending the U.S. Capitol Christmas tree lighting, and enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you.
play some more.
Oh, play more?
I guess so.
Why don't you grab someone from the book?